We acknowledge that we are on the land surrounded by water, originally inhabited by indigenous peoples who have traveled this area since time immemorial. This territory is within lands honored by the Wampum Treaties, agreements between the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, Lenné Lenape, and allied nations to peacefully share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. Specifically, we would like to acknowledge the presence of the Three Fires Confederacy, Ojibwe, Odawa, Potawatomi, and Huron-Wendat peoples. We are dedicated to honoring Indigenous history and culture while remaining committed to moving forward respectfully with all First Nations, Inuit, and Métis.
Graduates, families, friends, staff, it is my pleasure and honor to be able to address you this evening on behalf of the Board of Trustees. All of my colleagues and I would, of course, prefer to be with you in person for this occasion. However, I know that you understand why that's not possible right now. I hope you also appreciate, as we do, the effort of your school community to create this presentation to acknowledge, at this time, the class of 2020. This has been a difficult period for everyone, students, their families, teachers, and administrators. It has been, in every way, a crisis but not a catastrophe. We have, with the highest intention and incredible creativity, continued to provide high-quality educational opportunities in as manageable a format as possible. I am proud that we have shown and seen exceptional strength, fortitude, and resilience. But that is merely my perspective. The most important assessment, however, should be your own. How did you perform as an individual, as a citizen, as a student? This should not just be applicable to the past few months, though. Your greatest, your most sincere responsibility should always be to yourself during an emergency, as well as each and every day. We are marking your achievements in school to date. So I hope you smiled today and said, well done. You have made it through these past few months, but more significantly, you have endured all kinds of different tests over your years in school. You may not have chosen all these challenges, but you have accepted them and done what was required to succeed. I urge you to use the experience, recent and former, to continue to strive and to achieve. I look forward to the opportunity of congratulating you face to face at the appropriate time and in the appropriate fashion. Congratulations, and I wish you much success in your future. Thank you very much.
Students, families, friends, staff, we've been through a lot in the past few months. No one could have imagined how one tiny organism could have altered so much in our lives. How we interact with one another, how we behave on a day-to-day basis, how we teach, and how we learn. But COVID-19 has changed many things, possibly forever. This emergency has also caused us to discover a great many things about ourselves, good things, such as our immense capacity for respect, empathy, and how we can succeed independently. Until recently, the changes you were most concerned about would be typical for grade eights. A new school, new teachers, new friends, and new educational challenges. 6 months ago, I would have recommended that you embrace those developments and genuinely enjoy the adventure. Today, I'm inclined to temper that advice, to be cautious and deliberate about the fresh demands you will face. However, you need not fear change of any kind, whether it's going to high school or tremendous societal upheaval that we are now experiencing. As communities and as individuals, we've done exceptional things to deal with what we have been required to endure. You have been well prepared for anything that may happen in high school and in your lives as adults. I am very proud of the way we have accepted recent events, adapted, and overcome our struggles. I think it's a reflection of many of the things that you've learned in elementary school, knowledge and skills that just can't be measured by a grade. The people who are now saving lives, working on vaccines, and developing safeguards for future possibilities were once where you are now. There was likely something that happened to them when they were your age that was the inspiration for what they are doing now. Change is a fact of life. Don't allow any disappointment you've experienced recently to influence your outlook. You are ready to start making a difference in the world, and you can't do that with a pessimistic attitude. Be positive, be encouraging, and be safe. I'm looking forward to learning about everything you discover and witnessing the changes you bring about in high school and in your communities. Congratulations.
My name is Lori Hughley, and I'm the very proud principal of Harrow Public School. When we all walked through those front doors on September 3rd, none of us could have predicted how this year would end. And while we all wish this day could be a little bit different, nothing changes the fact that we have this amazing group of graduates to celebrate. The last 3 months may have been beyond our control, but the past 10 years of elementary school have been filled with accomplishments. Learning and friendships, heartache and joy, wonder, and all of those moments are the moments I would like to focus on today. I've had the pleasure of knowing these graduates for the past 5 years, but moms and dads and grandmas and grandpas and aunts and uncles and guardians, you have had the absolute pleasure of watching these young people grow from infancy. A little taller, a little bolder, a little more curious, more expressive, a little more artistic, each and every one becoming a unique individual capable of so much. So thank you, parents. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to partner with you and share in the shaping of this amazing individual. Students, for all of you, this is the first of many graduation celebrations you will have in the future. And what I love about graduation is that it's really all about your hard work, your goal setting, and your personal accomplishments that'll get you to the next level. This becomes even more important over the next 4 years. These next 4 years will help shape your entire future, so work hard and create endless possibilities for yourself. Since kindergarten, you've been focused on the A, B's, and C's of life. And for the next phase of your education, I would like you to focus on the B's. Be a trailblazer. Thinking outside of the box can take you to amazing places. Be humble. Appreciate what you have and be grateful for your opportunities. Be courageous. Never be afraid to ask for help. We all need it sometimes. And finally, be dedicated to being the best version of you you can. It really is the most important job you have right now. So together with your family, friends, teachers, and other special people in your lives, you have shared guidance, care, love, and many lessons that have made you the person you are today. But always remember that it is you that has control over your life, and now is the time to take ownership of those paths. Know, though, that you don't have to do it alone. There are many people in your life to help guide you towards your successful future. The next part of your journey begins now.
Dear graduates, I congratulate each of you on a successful journey through your elementary years as you receive your diploma. A diploma that in part signifies the closing of one chapter and in part opens the beginning of a new one, a new beginning in which you will continue to learn. You will learn in your day-to-day classes as you move through high school. You will learn from your experiences. You will learn from the decisions you make. And yes, sometimes we make the wrong decision or we choose the wrong path. To make a mistake is human nature, but more importantly, you will have opportunities to correct those mistakes and make them right again. Seize those opportunities. When you know better, do better. Never give up trying to do better. Within each of you lies a great power and the ability to make a difference in this world. Your parents and guardians have contributed to this great power, and your teachers each have had a hand in developing this greatness. Harness this great power. Advocate for yourself and advocate for others. Do good for yourself. Do good for others. Do good for this world. To the 2019-2020 graduating class of Harrow Public School, I sincerely wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Congratulations to each one of you. Good luck, Hornets.
Welcome, graduates and families, to our grade 8 graduation celebration. What a year it has been. It hasn't been an easy one, but I'm so proud of the way our graduates have handled it. Graduates, I'd like to send you off with a few words of advice as you move on to your new adventures. Never forget the power of effort, hard work, and perseverance when reaching for your goals. Don't be afraid to take risks in your learning. Remember that along the way, you will make mistakes and will be faced with difficult choices. But when we make mistakes, we learn from them and we move on, because mistakes are simply an opportunity to make our brain grow. As you move on to the next phase in your young lives, there will be many changes. Don't run from those changes, but embrace them. Gail Sheehy once said, "If we don't change, we don't grow. And if we don't grow, we aren't really living." Graduates, I wish you all the best in your future adventures. And as Dr. Seuss once wrote, "You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way." Congratulations, class of 2020.
Grade 8s, it's been a pleasure getting to know you over the last 2 years. As a group, you've learned to work together and have a positive attitude while respecting each other's differences. As individuals, you've learned to be authentic to yourselves while respecting the needs of other people around you. Your grade 8 year was not what you expected, and it's okay to feel the loss and mourn the things you missed out on. However, we must always look to the future. On top of COVID-19, several other serious issues have come to the front of society. The Black Lives Matter movement, the way Canadians have treated First Nations, Métis, and Inuit people, the treatment of LGBTQ community, as well as climate change, are all serious issues that face your generation. These issues all give you a chance to make positive change in the world. Take a minute and ask yourself, how can you be a part of that positive change? Congratulations and good luck, graduates.
Hi, graduates, friends, and family. I too would like to welcome you to our first and hopefully last virtual graduation. I hope you're all well. I hope you all stay well. Sit back, relax, enjoy the broadcast, but most of all, congratulations, grads. Typically, we would have a valedictory speech delivered by one student, but I think we can all agree that 2020 is shaping up to be anything but typical. When we asked for the submissions of speeches, we received only 5. But wow, they were fantastic. We were at a loss. We could not possibly choose. As we alluded to previously, graduating during a pandemic is not typical. We all agreed that during these unique times, instead of choosing one student, we would choose all 5. The following students have earned the honor of representing their classmates as valedictorians of Harrow Public Schools graduating class of 2020. Caitlin Fitzpatrick, Megan Marentate, Madison Mutterback, Megan Pouget, and Samantha Wright. We are so proud of these young ladies, as they were not only able to provide a walk down memory lane for our graduates, but they eloquently captured the essence of what it must be like for young people graduating in such uncertain times. The beautiful, heartfelt words and voices of each of our valedictorians will be featured throughout our broadcast.
Good morning, afternoon, or evening. I mean, who really keeps track of the time of day anymore? Before I get started, I'd like to thank our amazing teachers for putting this video all together since we can't have the traditional graduation. Hello, everyone. Most of you know me, but if you don't, I'm Megan Puget. It is a great honor to be on here and getting to remember and say goodbye to our exciting, embarrassing, but life-learning elementary school experience. I'd like to express my appreciation to all of my teachers, friends, and family members who've helped me get to where I am today. 10 years ago, our parents dropped us off for our first day of kindergarten, which I'm sure most of us were excited, but pretty nervous because it was a new experience we had to have. There were many happy and sad tears from both students and parents because we had to go from being at home all day doing whatever we wanted. Well, I mean, 10 years later, we're doing the same thing because of COVID, but the point is, we had to go to school, follow a schedule, and have many rules. But look at us now, finishing elementary school 10 years later. We couldn't have done it without the help of our guardians, but mostly the amazing Harrow Public School staff who've taught us the basics like the alphabet and counting to more harder stuff like algebra and French. So merci, Madame Bissonnette, pour nous enseigner le français parce que ce sera important dans le futur. Our staff have taught us that winning a gold medal isn't everything, but when you try your best, put all of your hard effort into it, and you're happy about it, you should be winning a gold medal in your own mind. Most of us, or at least I am, are super nervous for our next intense journey, high school. High school can sound pretty intimidating because it's a place where we'll be testing new things, finding the person we truly are, and where we'll meet many new people. Although we might fail a few tests and have to make big decisions, which we might make mistakes, it's a place for growth, so don't be scared to step out of your comfort zone and try new crazy things. We haven't had quite the great, rememberable grade 8 experience, but I reflect from the past few years and see how grateful we should be for everything we've had. In the upcoming years, we'll be distant at many different high schools, which sounds extremely scary to me because I've grown up with all of you. But we'll get to share our ideas, passions, and strengths with our new upcoming classmates, which could be our lifelong friends. But with how the technology is these days, I hope that we all can stay in touch. To all of my classmates, you all have talents that range from the arts, academics, and athletics. But in my eyes, you all have the gift to be kind to everyone, so make sure you keep that through your future. Even though this is personally a sad time, since we're all moving on, remember that when life gives you really hard times, it's not to punish you or to make you feel like you're a failure, but it's to make sure you put your best into things. Remember that teachers aren't giving you lots of work just for fun, but that they're helping you get closer to reaching your goals. And remember that we've been given such rich opportunities in such a safe and happy environment. And I believe that we can overcome any obstacle life gives us. And we should, because if we don't, we're wasting our potential. Thank you to our amazing teachers, Ms. Carey, Ms. Selkirk, Mr. McLean, Madame Bissonnette, Ms. Collier, to our amazing principal, Ms. Hughley, and vice principals, Mr. Vickers and Ms. Kettler, for our grade 8 year, and teaching us how to be good individuals and learners for the future. And remember to work hard, play fair, and be kind to everyone.
Thank you. What does it mean to have perseverance? Is it to complete a task you don't enjoy doing? To move forward in something when you feel you cannot? Or is it simply the act of not giving up when things get difficult? Over the past 10 years, we have all put hours of effort into making it to this day. The day we would have walked across the stage as all of our friends and family cheered. Now that circumstances have changed, we were all forced to persevere and move on. During this strange time of online learning, we have all become closer as classmates and as friends. It would not have been without the guidance and support of our teachers throughout the years, who taught us to be strong leaders and caring individuals. More specifically, I would like to thank Ms. Piazza, our grade 6 teacher who motivated us all to be the best versions of ourselves. Most importantly, thank you to all the parents and guardians who have helped to get us where we are now. I can only imagine how challenging that has been. Under their supervision, we have all shared many unforgettable moments. Like the time our teachers rebooked our trips to the ropes course 7 times before we actually went. Or the time we all crammed ourselves in a small bathroom at the art lab just to write on the walls with Sharpie. We will share the memories of arriving at Swim to Survive over an hour early and playing running Pictionary, or watching movies before the breaks. Even though our year has been cut short, it is those memories that will stick with us forever. I assume we can all agree this grade 8 year was not at all what we had in mind. Between the school strikes and online schooling, this school year has been unique to say the least. Although, I do suppose these events have made the year more unforgettable. Now as we go off to high school, some of us together and others starting new, we will all remember our distinctive last year at Harrow Public. Life is about perseverance and strength, not waiting for things to get easy. Our futures rely on what we do now, especially in surreal times like these. Oprah Winfrey once said, "Do the thing you think you cannot do. Fail at it. Try again. Do it better the second time. The only people who never tumble are those who never mount the high wire. This is your moment. Own it. Graduating class of 2020, this is our moment. Congratulations."
The Academic Excellence Award is given to the student in each graduating class with the highest overall average in academic subjects. These students are a fine example of Aristotle's quote, "We are what we repeatedly do." Excellence, then, is not an act, but a habit. I am honored to present this award to 3 students who, since the start of the school year, have consistently set and achieved high goals for themselves. They are incredibly driven and hold themselves to very high standards. I am confident that this is one of many accomplishments these young people will achieve as they move on to high school. Congratulations, Caitlin Fitzpatrick, Kale Marentate, and McKenna Russell.
The University of Windsor Alumni Association Award is presented to students who show a dedication to their schoolwork in all subject areas. These students consistently achieve at a high level, and this year's winners are Paige Ashley, Sophia Chisholm, and Madison Mutterback. Congratulations.
The recipients of the STEM Award are students who not only excel academically in the study of science and mathematics, but who also demonstrate a passion for the subjects. These students consistently demonstrate curiosity and perseverance in problem solving. They not only accept challenges, but seek them out regularly. I am honored to present the STEM Award to Alyssa Bergeron, Joseph Dumichel, and Danielle Gagnon.
To excel in any area of the curriculum, it takes more than hard work and excellent work habits. To excel in the subjects of history and geography, it takes passion, a passion in humanity, a passion to learn about how we have treated our planet and the humans who inhabit it, a passion to learn from man's past and current deeds, whether they be incredible feats of bravery, compassion, engineering, and discovery, or shameful ones of greed, cruelty, and ignorance. Along with this passion, these three young people bring their excellent work habits, keen insights, and worldly knowledge to class every single day. Congratulations to this year's Social Sciences Award winners, Haley Hanchar, Madison Mutterback, and McKenna Russell.
It's my honor to present this next award to someone that has the gift of gab. No word of a lie, this young lady will write thousands of words just for fun. She writes lyrics to songs and her stories flow endlessly. Congratulations, Paige Ashley. This young lady creates visual masterpieces with ease and precision. She not only demonstrates technical expertise, but also an incredible level of creativity in her works of art. Congratulations, Sophia Chisholm. I was very fortunate to gain this very talented student his last year of elementary school. Music is in this young man's blood. He plays trumpet, piano, drums. I asked him to learn the trombone, and he did with ease. I'm sure I'm missing some. He was in my classroom every day playing an instrument, sometimes teaching others. He has a great gift, and I'm honored to give this award to Caden Majorotti.
This award recognizes a student that demonstrates exceptional skills in the French language. Caitlin has a sound understanding in communication, reading, and writing. Not only does she go beyond the expectations of any task, she also adds creativity and challenges herself in all assignments. Caitlin has consistently shown a high level of interest and enthusiasm for learning a second language. She works well independently and in collaboration with her classmates. Félicitations, Caitlin. Je suis très contente de te présenter le prix d'excellence en français.
Good evening. Tonight, I have the pleasure of presenting the Council for Exceptional Children Award. The individual who will be receiving this award demonstrates leadership qualities, a growth mindset, and a positive attitude. This student takes on new challenges, is always willing to help peers and teachers, and sets goals and works hard to achieve them. He has developed into a confident and successful student. Congratulations, Silas Braun.
This student has been a leader on Harrow team since his early days of junior volleyball and basketball. He's been a major part of several championships and filled the gymnasium with pennants. His quiet, calm leadership, combined with elite athletic capabilities, are on display regardless of the sport he is playing. On top of all school sports, he is a standout golfer and hockey player, yet always makes time for his academic work. The Male Athlete of the Year goes to Kale Marentate.
The Female Excellence in Athletics Award is being presented to Aanora Seagull. Aanora has demonstrated her coachability, team spirit, effort, skill, and dedication in the many school teams she has been a part of and in her phys ed classes. Aanora works diligently to reach her goals in both athletics and academics. She is an excellent example of perseverance and growth mindset. Congratulations, Aanora.
The winner of this year's Joe Fernandez Unsung Hero Award goes to a student who demonstrates kindness, compassion, and caring for her classmates. She's loyal to her close friends and values her family. She's creative and demonstrates a hard work ethic every day. Congratulations to Megan Puget.
It's such a privilege to present this award to a lovely wee girl. She always has a smile on her face, story to tell, and I know has the confidence to do anything she wants in the future. She has a wonderful, supportive family who I hope will be more than willing to let me tag along with them to Ireland next time they go. Congratulations, Hope Moore.
The recipient of the Ontario Principal Council Award should demonstrate the qualities of a model citizen and exemplify leadership skills. It is my absolute pleasure to recognize Megan Marentate this year. Over the years, Megan has demonstrated dependability, responsibility, and a strong sense of community through her volunteerism around the school. Congratulations, Megan, and I wish you all the best. It is my pleasure to present the Kingsville Cavalier Award to a student who gets involved in her school and in the community. The Cavaliers are always on the lookout for a special grade 9 student who is outgoing, willing to step out of their comfort zone, take risks, and get involved. We hope you will get involved next year and make your freshman year at Kingsville District High School a very rewarding experience. Congratulations, Haley LaLiberty!
This award is presented each year to a student who displays exemplary volunteerism in school and our community. This young person never fails to impress with her awareness of the needs in our community. She is a dedicated cadet and a rescuer of baby possums. Without her help in the school, many children would go without breakfast on Wednesdays or popcorn on Fridays. I am so proud to present this award to Ari Wilson.
The recipients of the Blake Clifford Got Your Back Award are two students who are honest, accepting, and loyal. They are two young men that can always be counted on to do the right thing. They are true models of kindness and integrity, and any one of their peers would be lucky to have them as friends. It is an absolute honor to present these awards to Chris Nason and Kieran Watkins.
The School Safety Patrol Award is given to a student who has completed the CAA School Safety Patrol training program and takes responsibility as a school safety patroller seriously. A patroller is an extra set of eyes, ears, and helping hands at school crossings and on buses. Someone who keeps students safe when crossing the road and when students are getting on and off buses. A patroller is someone who exhibits leadership skills and acts as a role model for his or her peers. As a bus patroller, the student chosen for this award has demonstrated leadership and acted as a role model while carrying out the responsibilities of road safety. I will quote his bus driver as saying, "He is great with the kids and he sets a great example for the other students." This year's School Safety Patrol Award goes to Xavier Sweet. Congratulations, Xavier, and thank you for helping to make school zones safer.
The following students have achieved excellence in all learning skills this school year. The following students have achieved an average of 80% or above this school year.
Once I found out I was one of the valedictorians, I was filled with joy, but also quite nervous. I immediately went online to look for tips for public speaking. Now I realize the trick to pretend the audience is in their underwear won't be working. It's been around 10 years, 120 months, and 3,000 days. That's how much time we've spent at Harrow Public School. Most of our childhood has been in that building with each other. We're kind of like a huge family that's forced to see each other 5 days a week. It's weird, leaving elementary school. It's like finally leaving a prison and saying goodbye to a second home, all at once. We've made friendships that could last a lifetime and memories we will never forget. We've all grown so much this year.
If you told me a year ago that I was a valedictorian, I would have fainted. I, for one, have learned a lot this year, like how to find the area of a circle, which I never would have figured out without my amazing math teacher, Rob from Math Antics. And I learned how to hide your gum in Miss Selkirk's room so you won't have to write the gum essay. The first day of grade 8 felt like being put as a driver in a bus, but before you're one of the annoying kids in the back. We had more responsibilities and our homework became more challenging. Luckily, our teachers acted as a GPS to help guide us through the year. Even though we got annoyed when they made us make a U-turn, they always, well, usually, ended up being right. There were a few bumps on the road and we got lost a few times, but we were able to find our way. High school's coming up next, and the thought can make one nervous and excited at the same time. I mean, we're leaving the place that practically raised us to the great unknown. Some of us are upset to leave because we've been here most of our life, while others are excited because we've been stuck here most of our life. I think most of us are somewhere in the middle, wanting to stay but ready to leave. And I think the teachers might be getting a little tired of us anyways. I know a lot of us are upset for missing the last bit of our school year, but I heard this story that changed my perspective. It's about this boy who skipped into his yard with a baseball and a bat. He yelled, "I'm the greatest hitter in the world!" He threw his ball in the air and swung. He missed. Strike one. He threw the ball in the air and swung a second time. He missed again. Strike two. He paused, took a deep breath, and threw the ball in the air and swung. He missed. Strike three. "Wow, I'm the best pitcher in the world!" he yelped with joy. This story teaches us that we can always choose our reaction when facing adversity. So, we can mope and wish our year turned out differently, or we could be proud. We went through so many obstacles with the strike and the pandemic, but we got through it. We had a grade 8 year like no other, and we have overcome so much. I am so thankful to have gotten through this year with my amazing peers and teachers, and I guarantee this is a year we won't forget.
Memories by Madison Mutterbach. Here's the days that we got. Wish we were here, but we're not, because school brings back all the memories of everything we've been through. Here's the teachers here today. Here's the others along the way. Principal Hughley, Vice Principal Keller, Mr. Vickers, teachers, fellow graduates, parents, and families. All your support and guidance has helped all of us throughout our years at Harrow Public School. I'd like to welcome everyone to Harrow Public School's 2020 graduation video. There's a welcome sign as you enter a town which reads, "Welcome to Harrow, a great place to grow." This statement couldn't be more fitting to describe not only our small town, but our tight-knit Harrow Public School family. We all have grown so much since that very first time we walked through the doors on our very first day of school as young primary students, our backpacks in tow, barely draped on our shoulders, waving goodbye, and our parents uttering the words, "See you later and have a great day." Not knowing what to expect, fear of the unknown, and an incredible eagerness to learn, and of course, the nervousness we were all feeling. To where we have grown as a person and a student and have developed all these skills, like how to calculate certain things or how to use proper spelling grammar, and of course, some daily life skills that were taught by our teachers. Harrow Public School has been an amazing place to grow. With the help and guidance of our wonderful and dedicated teachers and each and every one of our faculty staff members, we have grown and developed into remarkable, intelligent, respectful, and kind individuals. We have learned countless lessons that we will carry with us for the rest of our lives. I would like to take a moment and reflect on our last and final year at Harrow Public School. Although the last 2 months have been filled with many obstacles and challenges, we have managed to come together and persevere as Harrow Hornets do. Over the years, we were taught to take on challenges and always do our best, even in tough situations. Over these last 2 months, we were tested on these skills, and I think we all have done a remarkable job. Our teachers have remained active and present in our everyday learning lives, always there for us and only a message or email away, willing to help or answer any questions we may have. Although online education can sometimes be difficult, it helped us to know our teachers were always there for us. Teachers, your devotion to us grade 8 students will forever be appreciated more than you could ever know. I, as I am sure all of you, will also cherish all the memories we have made here. Whether it be showing up each day, working side by side in our daily lessons or on a group project, helping out with events held throughout our school, participating and competing on one or more of our school teams, or hanging out and having a good laugh with your friends. All these memories that we have made will be remembered forever. I am proud and honored to be a part of the 2020 graduating class of Harrow Public School. Fellow students, I would like to wish you all the very best as you get ready to start this new chapter in your life. Our life is like a book. We are just starting our new chapter in life. So always remember, we are all unwritten, we are all identified, we are just beginning, the pen's in our hand, the ending unplanned. Today is where a book begins, the rest is still unwritten. We've been taught to work hard, be determined, and stay focused. With those qualities instilled in us, we are destined to succeed in whatever path we choose to follow. So here's to us, the graduating class of 2020. Here's to all the memories, because all the memories bring back and will forever bring back all of you. Thank you.
Good evening, teachers, fellow classmates, family, and friends. My name is Megan Marantate, and with me here today is a group of very talented, high-achieving individuals. This graduation is very different from previous ceremonies and the fact that we cannot be next to one another. But it won't stop us from sharing our memories and achieving our goals. We have finally reached the end of our grade school career, and the next chapter of our lives is just around the corner. All throughout grade school, we have all took chances and experienced change. Changes personally of setting higher goals for ourselves or stepping outside of our comfort zone. These changes have made us branch out to create new friendships and stronger bonds. One thing I would like to mention is our grade 7 ropes course field trip. Looking back today made me realize how close of a family we were and how each of us helped and supported one another to try new things and encourage each other to keep going. Going into grade 8 was a change, becoming leaders and being the big kids in the school. We all had to have ambition to set new goals for ourselves and get ourselves prepared for high school. One thing that got me through the day was Mr. McLean's dad jokes. Sorry, Mr. McLean, but your dad jokes were so cheesy that you had to laugh at them, because no one else would. Another thing I remember is when all the teachers threw rubber chickens over the wall at each other. And I would say that it was a good 10 minutes that was taken out of our math lesson. But it was okay, because we all wanted to waste time. Each and every one of those memories will always hold a spot to remember. We have all faced obstacles in life, and we are about to face more as we grow up. But we need to remember that the best view comes after the hardest climb. I would like to acknowledge the fact that we could have not gotten this far without the help and support of the Harrow public staff. The vast amount of knowledge we have with us today is credit that we owe to all our teachers that taught us curriculums inside the classroom and life lessons out of it. I would like to thank Mr. Vickers for putting together our leadership group and allowing everyone to have a chance to make a difference in the school and in the community. I would like to recognize Ms. Carey for her master math skills and her encouragement towards others to strive for more. Also, thank you to the parents who drove us to sports, events, and school activities. You had a big part in helping with that. Thank you to everyone who made our grade school career experience what it is today, and what it will be like to look back upon these memories. All the paths we took have led us to beautiful things, what we have learned on the way, not to follow others' footsteps, but make your own. But the next 4 years to define who we are one last time, we will never forget what we learned within these school walls. And we will never forget the chances we took or the opportunities we got. The memories in the school we made together will never be erased. So as this chapter comes to an end, we are more than ready to start a new one. Class of 2020, remember, graduation is only the beginning. Congratulations, happy graduation, and best of luck to the Harrow Public School Class of 2020.
no beaten path to show you what's next. You're the precedent. There's empty desk chairs, no caps in the air. You're smiling ear to ear, 'cause they're calling your name as if there's a stage. They're using cliches to make sense of the pain, and the last thing you're taught hurts more than you thought. The good old days are gone. Treasured the day, but memories fade like chemtrails over LA. You're picking out names, there's paper in frames. You're acting your age, but you're counting the years. Some disappeared, old photos are shared. Feels like you're there, and the last thing you taught hurts more than you thought. The good old days are gone.
Remember that with every piece of you.
ourselves, where eyes are never closing, hearts were never broken, time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me close until our eyes meet. Well, that's okay, baby, only words bleed. Inside these pages you just hold me, and I won't ever let you go. Wait for me to come home. 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 Inside the necklace you got when you were 16, next to your heartbeat where I should be, keeping deep within your soul. And if you hurt me, well that's okay, baby, only words bleed. Inside these pages you just hold me, and I won't ever let you go. I will remember how you kissed me under the lamppost back on 6th Street, hearing you whisper through the phone. Wait for